if you have an engine misfire on your Toyota Tundra or Toyota Sequoia, check out this video. There's a very simple fix that is most likely. I've had this happen. This will be the second time. So we're actually gonna fix this real quick. It takes 5 to 10 minutes to fix this misfire. So stay tuned. So this is my 2001 Toyota Sequoia. It has like 250,000 miles. It does have a misfire for the second time. So this is a little scan gauge, it's very old school. But anyways, it's usually a P300. That would be engine misfire cylinder one. Yeah, I don't know if you can hear that. Under acceleration, it will go bup, 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 right? It doesn't, it's mostly under load, okay? That actually sounds fine right there. It actually sounds fine, but under load, let's put it into gear. Like if I was to do, it's actually not misfiring right now. Actually sounds fine at the moment, but it definitely does have a misfire. And if you look at the codes, there's two that are not ready. I'll see if it will throw the code. It usually does not misfire when it's cold. As soon as it warms up, it starts misfiring. So it's P300, or there's 301, I believe, 302. Those are just the different cylinder numbers. So let's figure out what's wrong with the engine. All right, guys, so I just went ahead and get the truck out just so I can show you the misfire. So it's not supposed to sound like that, right? So here's normal partial throttle, very, very 10% throttle. Does not misfire. Watch, when I go like half throttle, the check engine light will probably come on. That's definitely a misfire. Here it's chugging along. It's cylinder number one is not working. So that's what it sounds like. So another way to test is you can actually take the coil pack on and off and see if you hear a change in the idle noise speed. So it's actually misfiring right now at an idle, so I'm gonna remove the coil and see if you can hear any difference. So we're gonna remove this and see if you hear any noise difference. No difference, right? No change. Let's remove this one. Definitely, right? So that is an indication that it could be the coil pack. So let's change it out. I've got a new one here that I got off eBay. It says it is an OEM Toyota, made in Japan, and I inspected it earlier, and it actually does look like it's from Japan, as it says. It does not look like it's been used, to be honest. I can't believe it. And I don't understand what the catch is, how I got it for $40 on eBay, but I can put the link below so you can go buy one if you need one. And I've removed this one before, but let's check it out. So this is probably the easiest job to change a coil pack. All you have to do literally is just change, this is like a tin, remove this, unplug this, pull it out. That's all you have to do is swap it out. Very, very simple. So all we're going to do is loosen this. Can you see? Loosen that. Loosen this bolt. Take off this clip. And we're gonna be done. And this one is actually, that's all it is, right? Just set that there. This guy will make a little noise. Might be a little hard to pull it out the first time. So this one's actually made in China. So I'm not sure the quality. I'm gonna keep this ring here. It looks like I'll keep that. It doesn't say Denso. Let's compare the two side by side. What you don't want to do is connect. So as you can see, this kind of has a gel top, whereas this one does not have a gel top. If you can compare the two there, you know, that's the underside of this one. This one doesn't look bad or anything, but so I'm not sure. This one comes with the ring here and everything. So let's just slide it on here, see how it fits. It's a nice connection there. And then our bolt is right here. Just gonna put this in and then plug it in and we'll be ready to go. I'm just gonna tighten this bolt, plug this in, and let's see if the misfire goes away. If I got ripped off on eBay or not, hopefully not. And I don't have the proper tools because I'm not at my house doing this. So I'll just snug this up. You don't want to over tighten it. It was really tight when I got to it. A little tighter than I would want it. That feels good to me. So let's fire it up and see if the misfire is still there. Misfire. Two codes, P1300, which is ignition coil, and then P1310. I will look that up. But let's go for a drive and see if the misfire is gone. All right, guys. First drive. All right. She's back. She's back. So there's no misfire. It's running on all cylinders now. And it sounds normal. It's not chug, 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 chug. Listen. That's my seatbelt light on because I don't have my seatbelt on. I'm like a good boy. But that will, that fixed the problem. So if you were curious how to change out the cool pack, it's probably the easiest thing in the world to do. And it's very rewarding because it's a cheap fix. It's an easy fix and you can do it yourself. And if you have any questions, use Google. Don't ask me because it's so simple. You should figure it out on your own. But I'll put that link down in there, and hopefully that helps you out. Hopefully that will help you out as far as finding a good, cheap coil pack on eBay. And that was Toyota. So I'm so excited to have this Toyota Sequoia running again. Because I got this truck for, you know, such a great deal. I got it for like $3,000. It's 2001. It had 220,000 miles on it. I've put like 30,000 miles on it. I drove it from Los Angeles back to Nashville. It gets good gas mileage, you know, good enough, 18 on the highway. It's got four-wheel drive. It has the million mile V8. The timing belt was changed, and I've been off-roading in it. It snowed 8 inches. The four-wheel drive was great. I can haul my mountain bike. I can haul my dirt bike. These are just great vehicles. They're getting harder to find. So I reckon even though this one is really ugly, the paint job is this maroon and it's been wrecked and had a cheap paint job, but it does the job. It does the job good. So it's got a little Flowmaster on there doing work. So anyways, hit the subscribe button if you like the video, and I'll keep you updated with the latest Mustang Automotive news. Thanks for watching. Over and out.